a solo exhibition of Forrest Jones' mind. I look into your eyes while he kissed your inner thighs. Made me so high. Got a little emotional masochism going on here. Try not to name my pieces because I feel like it puts the viewer in a box. Because when you give them a name, they're like, all right, I'm thinking like this, I'm gonna think in a way that'll fit the name of the piece. Definitely been influenced by the BTK killer lately. It just shows this inner rage that a lot of serial killers have. They usually have mommy issues. Shout out to the muses that trust my vision. Here we go, just a little affirmation and a reminder. You are a genius, you're bound by nothing, you are limitless. I was inspired by I watch Pinky and the Brain a lot. I watch it through the lens of a bipolar diagnosis. And there was this scene, I forgot what episode it was, but there was a scene in there. And Brain pretty much, they were in a cage and he made a key with a piece of paper and got themselves out the cage. And that shit just like blew my fucking mind to show how powerful our brains are. Some more emotional masochism. A little jealousy turns me like all the way on. I remember watching, it was right around the time I was dating someone that was into open relationships, and I really wasn't at the time, but I had this draw to cuckold and hot wife porn, and I wanted to do that in real time. And yeah, after I saw it, I was like, oh shit, this is lit. Speaking of the ex, we had a threesome, and that was when I was on my, that was a weird phase of my life. Cocaine, Xanax, Molly, all that shit. Don't do drugs, kids. I was gone off Zans when he put his hands down your pants. Yeah, I didn't remember a lot of that experience because I was gone out of my mom's Xanax. You know, when you get those type of text messages, you gotta put it on the canvas. Or when you kind of look through old ones. But I always kind of feel like the women that really, really, really do a number on me, they end up inside me, like they're a part of me. I carry them with me. I love just fucking doing shit backwards, breaking the rules. There really are no rules when it comes to art. Domination of submission. You would think more black people would be into it, or openly into it, considering all the BDSM that went on the plantation. All the dominance and submission. Remember that submission is a gift. Still in that coke phase, you broke up with me, we went to a wedding, we did coke, I cried. Like, I legit went to a wedding with my ex the same week she broke up with me. Like, if that isn't some fucking, like, glutton for pain and agony. Games too. I want to choke you to death and bring you back to life. Damn, who the fuck was I mad at, man? Swear it's better just put it on the canvas than to like hurt somebody else. Playing games too. A lot of them don't know what the fuck they want. And I don't know, I do embrace because they get so way more Ponzi schemes and multi-level marketing scams when it comes to dating than those men do. I really don't know how women kind of deal with this, because, like, man, we do some fucking foul shit. Alright, moving on. You're listening to, Senior Q's Shave Experience. The best song on there is Alone. So I was like, alright. in my mind, this will be pre-op and post-op, and I'll let you use your imagination when it comes to that. Addicted to affection as a motherfucker. So what happens when, like, a mother doesn't give you a lot of affection? So you chase it in emotionally unavailable women. It almost be like, damn, my mom couldn't show it for me emotionally. Like, how can I expect any of these women out here to do it? Or shit, or anybody. But that's what art and therapy is for. Damn, do you gotta have a degree in art therapy to teach that shit? Because I really want to get into it. I really want to get those tough emotions on the canvas. Got a little swinging situation going. Playboy swing or like Pornhub is definitely quality entertainment. There's, you know, a segment of population out here that just needs to step it up a bit to get satisfied. I don't know if I could do like a full-on swing situation. I don't know, teach their own. Really, really trying to save it down. It's like, yeah. I want to get over my commitment issues and we'll see. Keeping it moving. Oh, snap. It is not for everybody. But it is lit. If done right. I got put on a game in Iraq with an Air Force chick. She's black too. She got me through it and I was like, oh snap, alright, here we go. BDSM art, get on your knees like a good slut. A lot of times I just like to put it on the canvas. It doesn't necessarily be acted out. Talked about, yeah. But just because it looks good doesn't mean it's really for you, because, you know, people and their emotions and everybody can't handle that level. It's all good to each their own. But those who are, Shout out to all the times I've been cheated on. Which, don't feel sorry for me, because I think I've done it more on the flip side. So, yeah, I need to stop that shit. Well, I've done it. You know, I just try to be honest with everybody, but it is very much of a turn on if you're into that type of thing, to watch a partner be intimate with somebody else. That's the struggle of being artist, Gemini. I be having personalities balance, and one side will be like, hey, yo, let's be monogamous. Let's be one person. And let's just deal with that. And let's just keep, you know, be vanilla. And, well, just, you know, just do everything, you know, with one person. And then there's the other side that's like, oh, let's have all the fucking fun. Let's do this fucking wild shit and shit. So it's like, keep the balance. And I have to honor both sides, because if I don't, then it'll be out of hand. But, yeah. I think it's all about just being honest. Experience in the army 7 years and taught me how to kill people, man. We would go out to the bayonet training and just be stabbing this dummy. They'd be like, what makes the green grass grow? I'd be like, blood, bright red blood. So I'm like, to kill without mercy. And it's just ingrained in you, and they expect you to turn that shit off when you come back. Like, it used to be hard in jobs and shit, and motherfuckers were talking me crazy. I'm like, motherfucker, I will stab you. Like, I will choke you to death. I'm totally down to shoot you. Like, I'm totally fucking down. But luckily, a couple of mechanisms. And then, whenever I always remember when I used to be on school campuses, I used to be like, oh shit, that's how they get these school shootings off, because ain't nobody paying attention. I can do a 30 clip real quick, do a quick mag change, I can knock out another 30. It's the funny kind of sick shit I be thinking about. Because, you know, but even before I joined the Army, I used to watch those beheading videos on fucking LimeWire when the wars fucking pop off in Iraq. But don't worry, I'm definitely afraid of prison. What would you do? How would you handle watching your partner fucking somebody else? A little abstract, gotta show the range. Stated before, we've been fascinated by serial killers, Ted Bundy, Yo Dude, BTK. I want to take some more of those images and I'll put them together. My good old jab at capitalism, all capitalism, baptism by fire, no water, no power. I think I did this one when we had that snowstorm here in Houston, which was people's pipes were busted, people died like carbon monoxide poisoning. It's wild. Electricity is and water are like finite resources. Don't shake your kids, don't spank your kids, there's no need to hit kids at all. I had a defest when I worked for Child Protective Services. I had a case where I couldn't find the family of the baby, and I had to close it. And a couple months later, I got a call saying that the mom shook the baby and she died. Well, was on the way to dying, but yeah. Yeah, talk to the kids, yeah, there's no need to hit them. I know you could be frustrated, so yeah, just try the people around you to kind of help out. The domestic violence piece. So much domestic violence is going on. I think it's up now because of COVID. But, yeah, dudes, like, address your anger issues and those mom issues you have. Go get some therapy. Talk it out. Don't provoke each other, because that shit can go left real quick, like, in, he got game. There's really no need to put hands on each other, like, non-consensually. Some of that picture I took out in the cemetery. Fucking scary and shit, because I was like, oh, is it gonna fucking pop out of me like Thriller? Just keep putting the struggles in the art, man. Putting the struggles in the art. Snap, could it be a gangbang, or could it be the blue flame? You'll never know, you'll never know. Alright, here we go. I was inspired by my favorite scene at Roots. It's when they're at the bottom of the boat, and the one guy is like the chief or whatever, he tells them to get to know each other, learn each other's languages, so they can group together and fight the white man and take over the boat and go back to Africa. But, I mean, they end up learning each other's languages and then they tried and failed, but it was just inspirational that they were trying it all, because I could not imagine what the fuck was going on bottom of that damn boat. chick, she was a smoker. She didn't give me none. I was just like fantasizing. Has anybody ever ate the vagina of a cigarette smoker? Like, does it taste different? Every nigga is a star. Do, do, do. Every nigga is a star. Yeah, I don't mind the word. I don't have time to be arguing over semantics. I like, call me what you want, just don't call me bro. Oh snap, alternate universe type shit. Alternate universe, what could the blue people be? Could the black man be the overseer? Or could the black man be your oppressed by the blue people under the sun? We'll never know. Scarlet Rose, how are you doing? Enjoying the art? Yeah, I'm enjoying the art. Still kind of weird, but I'm enjoying the art. Oh, this is my favorite piece. Out of all of them, this is my favorite one. I definitely use it for some other shit. You like it, Jimmy? Yeah, I do. Appreciate it, Jimmy. Oh, man. Yeah. Oh, these chicks be having me strung out. Be having me strung out. It's like, maybe some more than others. Definitely some more than others. Poetry, too scared to love, scared to be responsible for someone's feelings. And my feelings with love. Snap, 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 snap. Some random shit. Took that one picture of you from, big old picture of the third ward in the building, but some people are like, where'd you find that? It's like, self in the third ward. Proud boys. Took these pictures in Kansas City a few months back. Chaos. Money cash homes. All the shit that comes with it. Distractions, drugs, pills. Abstract. So we got here. Kids teach love, adults teach hate, ain't that right? And last but not least, we have interpretation from my psychotic episode that I had August of 2019. went on a wild shooting trip, walked out my house, was fucking butt-ass naked. The police came. I think I was tased. I'm pretty sure I was tased. I ended up in the EMT ambulance. And that's when I saw, like, the life cycle. And, oh yeah, before that, I saw God. And I was like, he was like, turn your ass to do, run, got work to do. And yeah, then they got me. And then I was like, I'll show you my power, show you my power, my greatness. And then next thing, and I just kept hearing, like, slow down, calm down. Next thing I woke up in St. Joseph's, and it's downtown Houston, and I live in Second Ward, and I decided to, I was gonna walk home. And I was like, the fuck? So I ended up calling back, got a number through like 3 or 4 phone calls for my homie to pick me up, because I was missing, didn't nobody know where I was. And yeah, he got me. So, yeah. That is all. Thank you for joining me for this experience.